Welcome to Beetle Media, and you wonder how fast they stole your catalytic converter off of your Toyota Prius.
Fucking Toyota Prius.
He's already done. Well, I don't know. Let's see if it starts. Okay, so as you do when you cut off a catalytic converter on a car and it's open pipe, you have to see if it'll start, and if it does, see what it sounds like. So we're the keys to this ugly turd. God, it stinks so bad in here. Got a tailpiece. I mean, looks pretty good though. So, give myself some room to work with. So, you know. Yeah. It'll look gorgeous. Oh, that's where the dog thing is. Heavy.
20,620.
Truck weighs $16.
Oh. Dang.
I thought I heard a whoa.
Can I pull forward the truck over the side?
Go steal one of his plastic wheel chocks.
In the front? Good there?
Good.
Thank you. Leg day.
Bye-bye there.
It says 16,420.
Perfect.
Yeah, he only weighs 5,600 pounds. So it isn't a bad living truck either.
Okay, so the way it works, we brought in a van. It's a 2002 Honda Odyssey and a Schnitzer Steel. I don't know how they price these things, but they call them wet cars. So if they're... quit making so much noise over there. If there's gas and oil in the car, they call them wet cars. It's $110 a ton right now for cars at Schnitzer Steel. This is, I don't know what month we're in, but we're in 2021. March 26th or some shit. Yeah. March 26th. 3/26/21. That van weighed 4,200 pounds, and we ended up getting $231 for that van. I cut the cat off. The cat will probably sell between $200 and $300, and the battery will sell for $5. But that's how it works here.
That's pretty much how it works about anywhere. So you see there, he has a cigarette. Those are bad for you. He's pulling the winch line off, so that way we're gonna replace it with this
fibery style one.
It's a lot cooler. $19.96. Yeah, so hasn't been around for a minute. Then there's that and that, and then there's two behind me over there, and then there's another one down there somewhere. So that's what the day is doing.
Yeah.
You are ugly. Yeah, actually, yeah, that was kind of funny. There's a bunch of weird shit in there.
Can you remember back how that happened? You're not on the tire, you're behind it.
Behind it. Look.
It's the same way over here is on the other side. You missed. Yeah, about the same over here.
I gotta figure something out. It needs to go that way. So I think I'll just...
What about that? That block? That snatch block?
Yeah.
Little piece of aluminum about ready to fly off the truck. Where? Kind of. There we go. Now we're good. Oh. swear to God. Fucking holes in every pocket I own. Piss me off. Yo. Race cars. Race car stuff. And cleaning the tweaker van out. So. There we go. We have cutters and pliers. Oh, good Lord. Look at that plug-in. You know how old that plug-in is?
That fucking thing's not even there.
That is old. That thing was like a zillion years old. Wait. Aren't these? Oh. Probably isn't enough to mean anything. Pink gorilla. Seems like a porno, but I don't remember MGMUA having porn. What the fuck? ProShine. Advanced control systems. What's your favorite? My favorite is...
Oh my God, I'm keeping that for my son.
May, October.
Wow.
December. December, March. Dude, I am so having a hard time. I was like, well, I'm going to pick a cool one.
Oh my God, I'm keeping this for my son.
Oh, wow. Are you sure?
My son will love that.
Wow. I wouldn't.
Skylar Zelstra, you are getting this.
Wow.
Oh my God. This is the pull back and go action kind.
I would leave it in the packaging.
Oh yeah, it's going to be left in the packaging.
Okay, so I'm going to pick one in 3 seconds. All right, so it's toss up between the Porsche, oh the God. Mustang, so and the Daytona. One, two, three. God damn it. I was going to say Porsche, and then I was going to say the Dodge. So we're going to go with the Porsche, but I do love me a Daytona. Look at that one, too. Pretty cool. All right, comments down below. Which one is your favorite? They were all pretty cool cars. Getting back. It'll hold. Well, you have a little none now. Yeah, it ripped the front end off.
Back up.
Just pull the stump and see if it rips it out of the ground there. Yeah. I'm fairly certain that's what's holding it. Mother Nature is really attached to this one. I mean, the tree grew through the vehicle. You're pulling up the slack. Keep going a little bit. A little bit. You're almost there. That's tall. You're tight. Everybody clear? Everyone good? Clear. Give her hell. You might have to give her more hell than that. Huh. Might actually get that tone back. Yeah, all right. Yeah. Okay. You got the tree out. Yeah. Wow. Damn.
Got the radiator and the tree out.
Yeah, you wanted the radiator, right? Huh, that's the tree. Whew, all right, so now we're gonna rig it up again differently and see what happens. Wow, is that the sway? You think it's gonna hold? Maybe.
Go ahead.
I'm not sure what part broke, but something. This is reminds me of Alien. Or the Predator? Or the well, like,
oh Jesus.
Yeah, the tree coming out of the front of the van there was kind of like that part. What is that movie called? Predator? Yeah, you do.
I never watched that show.
Yeah, you do. What was it? Alien or something? Nor was I, but I've seen it. What was it? Alien or something with the space with the dog with the spaceship?
Space Cowboy?
No, I think it was Alien. Because there was Alien versus Predator, and Alien was the thing that walked on all fours with that big long head. A big long head.
You're solid now. All
right. Wait, so. All right, clear. Yeah, bro. Yeah, all right. It moved.
Hold on, I'm gonna do it again.
Let me get back here. All right, go. I'm out of the way. Let me get the wheels straight, see if I can. Never mind.
Hold on.
The wheels will never steer.
Gotcha. Go. Try it.
Yeah. It's gonna go now. Just.
That's good. Now if we pull that fucker this way.
Yeah.
It'll fucking
back the van is heading straight for the pile of for the fire, so
back over there.
You kind of need to drag it somewhere this direction.
How far am I pulling it that way?
I think about 10 feet or so. Where your truck lines are is about where he can back the bed up to, where your truck tire lines. So
not all the way this way, just a little bit.
Hey, how far are we trying to go? Like 10, 50 feet? All right, just a little bit. Good. Beautiful. Beautiful. Alright, well, we're almost out of here. It's been a long day. Really long day. I can't see anything with the lights. I mean, this old race car wheel. And another one. Those are cool. I would like mount it. I'd mount that to the wall and wrap my hoses on them. If I still had a garage. Check this shit out, guys. Check this.
You know other people do.
Nice.
Please.
Yeah. You want me to shut my camera off? Is it okay if I film a couple of the cars? Thank you. This is so cool. So you like using the aluminum foil and the masking tape?
Yeah, we usually don't have to use it.
Gets a super tight fit.
Yep. Now, when I'm masking a car, I'll use paper. But when it comes to bars and brake lines and
Okay.
hoses and shit like that.
Oh, yeah. Base, this stuff works awesome. Yeah. Okay, I'll remember that.
It is cheap.
This
it
is
a dollar store.
Yo, this is what I went to college for, was welding, tube and fabrication, stuff like this. I went to college for all this. All these things here.
Yeah.
Well, for winging it, man, your welds look really good, dude. Like, I mean, well, that one got cleaned up.
Those are husbands.
Yeah? These look hella good.
I'm the painter, he's the welder.
I feel it. That's what my best friend is.
I'm the driver, he's the crew chief.
All right. Hell yeah. What's it like driving these things?
I haven't drove one yet.
Yeah?
You go take a view of the Wall of Fame.
Yeah?
You'll see pictures and race cars and history and
this.
We'll be on the track tomorrow.
Really? I wasn't, yeah. Yeah. Those are the racing wheels.
What do you think?
Wow. Good luck.
This is incredible.
Wow. Look at those. Alright, these headers must fucking scream. What is this, just a 350?
Not just any old 350.
So 383 stroker? Like old school? Huh?
377.
A company called Progressive, they build ones.
The actual built for racing is $22,000.
Ho!
If you were to buy a brand new.
Brand new.
$22,000 brand new.
I got it for $7,500 for a gas. You got 1,000 laps out. They're guaranteed for four.
Wow.
They dyno at 627 horsepower and 600 foot-pounds of torque.
Fuck yeah!
At 7,800 RPM all day.
78? Well, how much does this thing weigh?
2,400 pounds for your driver. Full of fuel.
That's fast. That's really fast.
Mm. They're not like fucking quarter mile fucking fast.
Well, they're made for something different. Yeah, if you're trying to do a quarter mile, this
they
thing
do
would risk.
Mile an hour through the straightaway.
Yeah?
It's a girl, yeah.
That's so sick.
They're hitting about 100.
Wow, that's not a whole lot of room.
It's about an 8 mile.
Wow. That's incredible.
So I traded this car right here for that car.
Wow.
That one is race ready.
Yeah?
I did the 8 mile drives.
Nice.
One of the fastest Hornets out there.
Tracks on a 1/5 oval.
Top three car all day long.
1/5. An 1/8, 1/3. Like when we go down to California and shit, that track down there, they're probably hitting 120, 125. When they go into the turn.
This is my mom. She passed away like 6 years ago.
Sorry to hear that.
5 years ago. This is my stepdad. He's still kicking it.
Yeah.
You know, this is one of Ricky's old cars. Ricky's old car. There it is again. This was the car that's actually sitting outside underneath the cover.
Okay. So what happened to that one?
God, it just needs... needs to be put back together. This is our, that's my brother-in-law. That's the old car that's outside.
Hell yeah. Wow.
This is really old car before them all.
That's sick.
Wow.
TMI picture. That's his daughter.
Yeah?
That's that car you see outside, that's what it originally looked like.
Okay. That was me and my ex-partner, because we literally spent 10 hours every single day and an hour or so after work every single day, but Sunday.
I work with him, Joe.
Yep. Like, I knew that fucking idiot more than his fucking girlfriend did. She'd be asking me questions.
He's fucking getting all moody with me when he first got here about the fucking tire thing, and I'm fucking... All he did was ask a question, and he gets all pissy and starts snapping.
So that's me, and you're Tate, my best friend. And I'd start being an asshole and be like, "Why? What's your problem? Why are you so mad?"
You're supposed to be going to pick up the vinyl.
Well, that's what he said.
Yeah, I was supposed to go get the vinyl, but what, 2 hours ago?
Yeah, at least. That reminds me of Leroy. Off of Cletus and Cars. Reminds me of Leroy, this whole front lip. Oh, look at that old pump. Wow. So the whole car is better to buy it used. That one's about $7,000, $8,000. Not counting the motor, like.
Assembly out and it's going into a new block.
Okay.
So I have all the parts just waiting for the magic.
Wow.
And I need to buy a set of these. It's 165 per wheel.
I want to take a tire like this.
$650 for six tires.
Six tires? Why do you need six? Because the rear ones scrub out real fast?
It's the way the rules are set up, where you're allowed to start off the season with six.
Yeah.
And then you're only allowed to buy two every other race. That way it keeps the price down on tires.
Oh.
That way you're not getting beat out by the guy that's buying tires every single race.
Okay.
So you get six to start the season with, and then you're allowed two every other race. Or basically one tire a race, however you want to look at it.
Wow.
Unless you pop one, and then you're allowed another tire.
I can do more than
going up.
Oh, where is that? Where did I see it?
Here.
Wrong one?
Fuck. Keep them flat like this, straight together, because if you kick it over like this and you start ratcheting, this will go away. This will start kinking and let go. And the worst case scenario is this will actually kink on a bump and it'll let go while you're driving and you'll never know. Most of the time it'll break loose while you're ratcheting it, but just remember, you don't want this to be kinked over in any way. When you put it all the way down flat, that locks it. See how I left it up? All the way down locked, right?
Well, I kind of did a thing. I didn't know. No, it's all right, but it started going. You can kind of see how it started working its way over here.
I don't want that. I got it halfway down the wheel and across the suspension. I'm just hoping that it holds it. It looks like it will. It really is. I could kind of tell by the way the bed was acting when you were bringing it up. Right this second? I don't know.
pretty sure this van used to belong to Van Halen, so
yeah, I'm sure.
You call American Pickers and shit, that's what he used to say right there was Van Halen, you know. Things worth probably $2 or $3 million.
It says Colby. Right there. The only thing that was good on Colby Avenue was the car show. It happened once a year.
Oh, there might be paperwork in it somewhere.